Okay, so it's important to understand the proper donning and removal of the personal protective equipment, in this case, gloves. Our gloves are our next line of skin to help prevent any type of contamination into cuts, scrapes. You know, the hands are so easily abrased, hangnails, paper cuts, ways to actually get through that layer of skin. And that's why it's so important to have medical grade gloves. In this case, they're nitrile. This is really becoming more and more the common because of so many latex allergies. And so we're using nitrile today. When it comes to putting these on, there, you know, some of this is kind of common sense. But when I was in EMS school, you know, these guys would stick together sometimes. And so we would kind of blow them up a little bit. Not appropriate. We are not putting our mouths even to supposed clean gloves. We also don't want to get germs on the gloves. So we're not blowing them up. You know, now they're kind of powdered or they have some kind of coating on there and they're a lot better for getting them on. If your hands are real wet or sweaty, dry them off appropriately and the gloves will go on a lot better. You can also make sure that you've got the appropriate size. And for employers, it's important to get the appropriate size for your employees. If they have extra, extra large hands, you need to get a box of extra, extra large gloves. You know, giving them a one size fits all, and then they rip every time they put them on is not appropriate. So we're just gonna put these clean gloves on, normal way. We're gonna inspect the gloves to make sure there's no cuts, no holes, nothing obvious that's going to ruin the integrity of this barrier. But then when they're contaminated, now comes the most important part of this next skill, and that's removal of contaminated or potentially contaminated gloves. We're going to follow the glove-on-glove, skin-on-skin rule. In this process, it's important that we keep the contaminated materials on the glove and the non-contaminated to our skin side, but when we remove these gloves, we want to make sure that we're not accidentally snapping or popping the glove, which could run the risk of then nebulizing or spraying the blood on other surfaces or into other colleagues' eyes. So here we go. Glove on glove, I grab normally around the palm of my hand and I pull out to break the seal. I just slowly start to work my hand out of that glove while I wad that glove up into the hand. There's a couple thoughts there. Some people, some educators are a little more picky about not rolling this any more than you have to. I like to at least grab it, and I'm not squeezing it, but I like to grab it so that it's in the palm of my other hand. And here's why. Now when I do the skin on skin removal, look at, when I remove that, it encapsulates the waist. If I've got a bloody gauze in my hand, that's now two gloves in, and it's rolled into the inside pocket. Now, I use ideally a handless waist can. Make sure that you have the appropriate container or the appropriate liner per your regulations, and then into the appropriate trash it goes, and we're all set. After this, make sure we go and appropriately wash our hands or use rubbing alcohol as indicated.